Hello? Hello? Is anyone there? The library is closed. No reading after 2:45.
Alright, all you lazy little weasels. You all know what this means. You know what time of year it is. So put away your hopes and dreams, give up any social life you may have, and any extracurricular activities you may be part of. Tell your arts teachers to shove off, and lay the controls of your Nintendo U's to bed.
It's a Wii, Nintendo Wii.
It's not a Wii because I want nothing to do with it. For the next 2 months, this standardized testing will be your life. Learning is no longer an option. My classroom will not contribute to restructuring. I refuse to let any of you little worms drag me into the earth. No. No! But the testing! What about the standardized testing? Nothing is more important! Fine! Jennifer Diamond, you're needed in the front office.
See you on the flip side, Cecil.
You will call me Mr. Morgrew, or by heaven, I will end you. I will end you, Jenny Diamond.
You got some strong words, but you got stronger breath. Buy yourself some Wrigley's. I've got an appointment. Jenny, I love the new podcast. I'm a subscriber.
Doc.
I don't like it, Chief. I don't like it.
You don't have to like it. It's not your job to like it.
She's just a kid. She probably can't even tie her own shoes without her mother there to wipe her nose for her.
That doesn't make a lot of sense, Rocky.
Well, neither does giving her this case. It's my case, Tunchoffin.
She knows the underworld. She can go places you can't. Talk to people who clam up as soon as they hear your shoes squeaking in the hallway.
They're new shoes. I can't help it. I'm still breaking them in.
We need Jenny Diamond. Send her in.
Rocky Road is tons of fun. You two screws must be thinking hard because I'm sure I smell bacon cooking.
Hardy har har. Somebody call the Tonight Show. We have ourselves a comedian.
That's enough, you two. Save the jokes for Bazooka Joe. Jenny, we called you here for a reason.
Good. I was beginning to think this was a social call.
There's been a break-in at the library.
What library?
The school library?
Really? Most kids I know try to break out of a library, not into it.
That's the problem. Why would anybody want to break in? It's the safest building on campus. The district wouldn't have even put locks on the door if it wasn't for the copy machine.
So, let me guess. No video surveillance, no tripped alarms, no...
Nothing. We wouldn't have even known something was up if it wasn't for Mrs. Gizzard, the librarian. She was there a few nights ago when one of the break-ins occurred.
How many break-ins have there been?
Four that we know of, maybe more.
So that's why you need me.
The 31st Flav over here couldn't find squat, is that right?
Something like that.
You're full of beans, all of you. A whole can of beans.
What will it be, Jenny? Will you help?
What's in it for me?
School pride.
Not good enough.
We need you, Jenny.
No, we don't, Chief. I can handle this case.
Yeah, I'm sure the culprits are trembling as we speak.
I saw you on YouTube, Jenny. What was the name of your last case? Jenny Diamond, the Angry Squirrel. Something like that?
Yeah, something like that.
What did it take to get you on this case?
What do you need me for when you got a regular Sam Spade on the payroll?
Come on, Jenny.
Sorry, tons of fun. You want charity work? Call the Salvation Army. It's not my scene.
Jenny, wait.
See you on the flip side, boys.
Don't worry, Chief. She'll only slow me down.
You got 2 days. You're back mopping up vomit elementary school. Got it?
Here we see the alpha female, Maggie, again asserting her dominance over the pride.
No chicken fingers. We're in training, you cow.
No effort is made by the lesser female to confront Maggie. Any minor rebellions are quashed before they even have a chance to begin.
Bipple need chicken fingers. Bipple need to make way for wrestling. Bipple rules. Go Mustang wrestling.
Spying on cheerleaders again, Doc?
No, it's just a science experiment.
Yeah, right. What are you gonna call this one? When good cheerleaders go bad?
It's an anthropological analysis of the social strata in high school athletics.
Sounds fascinating. You free tonight?
Well, I've got some homework.
Good. Meet me here tonight at 9.
But I've got a paper to read.
And bring the equipment. It's something big.
Big?
Tons of Fun personally asked me to take the case.
And you agreed?
Of course not. I don't work for the Fuzz. I'm a free agent, baby.
So why are you investigating it?
To make Rocky Road look like a fool.
Count me in. So what exactly are we looking for again?
I'll know it when I see it.
Great.
It'll be suspicious.
Very helpful, Jenny. Is that suspicious?
No, that's just creepy.
I'm gonna film it anyway. It'd be great for a good ambient shot. Would a shadowing figure skulking around the library at night be at all suspicious?
Let me see that. Can you zoom in? Can you see who it is?
I can't tell.
Do you know what they're doing?
Looks like they're putting paper into an old yearbook.
What?
Can't tell.
You're a regular Encyclopedia Britannica. You know that.
Gosh, you ain't gotta be rude or anything. Jenny? Thanks for telling me on the move. Real considerate, Jenny. What'd I miss?
Nothing much. A pack of sinister cheerleaders and their wicked queen. The usual.
What are cheerleaders doing here this time of night?
I don't know. Practicing their high kicks?
Well, did you ever figure out what's going on in the library?
No. Whatever it was, they didn't want me to find out. Let's come back tomorrow. Whoever's in there is long gone by now.
This is getting insane. I'm gonna go home and dent that footage.
Yeah. Have fun with that. I'll see you tomorrow. I'm late. Melgrew kept me after class.
Why?
I don't know. I didn't really do anything.
And he just let you go?
Not really. I called him a whiny fascist and walked out.
Classy. So, I can't believe I'm wasting my lunch for this. My mom made me a head cheese sandwich. I love head cheese.
Yeah, well, as much as I'd hate to interrupt that culinary experience, we've got a mystery to solve.
Yeah, I'll call Scooby in the game. At least they had a car.
Yeah, the mystery machine was sweet.
What are you two doing here? It's lunchtime.
We're looking for a book.
But it's lunchtime.
Yeah, we know. We're looking for a book.
But it's lunchtime.
This could take all day.
Just tell us where you keep the old yearbooks.
Students don't ever come in here during lunchtime. Is this some sort of surprise investigation from the district office?
Sure. We're undercover. We're here for a surprise library evaluation.
Surprise!
Oh,
why? Now, tell us where you keep the old yearbooks.
Item 10.
Thanks. Mind if we check it out?
Oh, be my guest. I'm sure you'll find everything in order.
Quality control.
Oh, okay. That way.
What does that mean?
I don't know, but I got a hunch.
Is everything in order?
Yes, everything looks tip-top to me.
Oh, good, good. You know, you guys should really, you know, rethink your surprise investigation characters. I had you figured out, you know, within the less than 2 seconds, you know. You're a real Charlie Chan.
So, when do people normally come into the library?
Never. I've never had a student use the library before.
Really? Never?
Never. The only thing people use in here is the copying machine, but that's only for use by the teachers.
Well, this is all fascinating, and it'll all be in the report. You're doing a great job here, really. Top drawer, but we've really got to scoot along. Lots more libraries to inspect. Busy, busy day. Bye.
Okay, goodbye, and good luck.
Where are we going?
The note said the dirty boot, right?
Right.
Well, where can you find the dirtiest boots on campus?
Ag?
Hey, Pooper Scooper. What you gonna do with that pig sticker?
Stick a pig.
Wow, there really is no sarcasm in the word ag, is there?
No.
Let me see your boots, Cletus.
Got eyes, don't you? And my name ain't Cletus.
Fine, Jasper, whatever. Where do you keep your other boots?
You know, ma'am, around these parts it's always nice to end a sentence with the word, please.
These parts? It's the school farm. I can see the bike rack. We're not exactly wandering through Appalachia.
What do you want with my boots anyway?
What were you doing breaking into the library last night?
What
does a dirty boot mean?
You're speaking in riddle, short stack.
I know it's you and your turd-tapping buddies. No one else on campus has dirty boots.
Listen, every ag kid on campus has been at the county fair for the last week. And second, why would a chicken scratch where there ain't feed?
I'm sorry, I don't speak yokel. Could you citify that last bit up for me?
Why would an ag kid have anything to do with the library? I don't even know where the library is.
But what else could the dirty boot mean?
I don't know, and I don't care. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm got to go do some stuff before I head back to the county fair. I am the Lord your God. Fear me, Peggy.
I hate the school farm.
Yeah, it really makes you appreciate ceramics.
Well, 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 look what the hog crapped out. Princeton Shopping wants to see you, Jenny. Seems a report about you calling a teacher names.
God forbid.
Come with me. Leave the entourage.
Entourage? I'm not an entourage. I am a documentarian. Chronicler of events. I helm a dying art.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary. How does your garden grow?
Real original. What do you want, Jenny?
Just friendly conversation. Gossip it with a girlfriend.
I could get kicked off the team just for talking to you.
So why are you still talking?
I'm not sure if getting kicked off the team would be such a bad thing.
What happened to your wrist, Miss Mary? And don't tell me you fell off a ladder. I'm not in the mood.
We were practicing lift, and Maggie dropped me. She said I was too heavy.
Sounds like a tough break.
Yeah, accidents happen, I guess.
You think she did it on purpose?
I should go.
Miss Mary, what are the cheerleaders up to?
I don't know.
Don't play with me, pussycat.
I don't know. I'm sorry. I can't.
Listen, Miss Mary, I'm through playing games. You got me, kid? Tell me what's going on.
I can't.
Tell me what's going on or I'll snap your other wrist faster than a beatnik can compose a haiku.
Ow! Jenny, please, I don't know anything. I just follow directions. I'm not part of the in crowd. I just do what Maggie and her cronies tell me.
You gotta get me close, Mary. Get me on the inside.
There's gonna be a pool party at my house this weekend. I'll see if I can find anything out. I swear.
Gotta do better than that, Miss Mary. I want an invitation.
It's cheerleaders only.
To the pool party, Jenny must be invited or you will suffer. 575, Mary. That's a haiku.
Stop. You can come. But they can't know it's you. They'll all turn against me. Please, Jenny, I'm afraid.
Don't worry about that. I'm a master of disguise.
This is your disguise? Why don't you just put a bag over your head and call yourself the unknown guest?
Why don't you call off the dog, sweetheart? We'll get along much better that way.
So, are you supposed to be a burn victim or something?
No, I'm your cousin recovering from plastic surgery.
What about Donald Dork over there?
Donald Dork?
Oh, sorry. That's just what the cheerleaders call you.
The cheerleaders call me Donald Dork?
Mm-hmm. Well, I call him Doc. He's my Watson.
Why don't people just call me Donald? Or Don? Or D-Skillet?
Yeah, well, D-Skillet here is gonna hide somewhere and film any confessions or suspicious goings-on.
It'll make a great supplemental film for my anthropology project.
Well, fine, whatever. I just don't want anything coming up on some creepy website.
I don't have a website.
Come on, D-Skillet. Let's hide you somewhere before anyone else shows up.
I don't know about D-Skillet. It sounds so...
Dorky? So...
Yeah, that's the word I was looking for.
Dorky.
Dorky!
Thank you. opened my eyes at the bus. It was all very subtle. I don't think anybody would have noticed if I didn't tell them.
I got my cheeks pegged once.
$10,000. That's how much it cost. You know, my stepmom Carla says that's much more than our gardener makes in 1 year.
They wired my jaw shut too. I lost 17 pounds just in time for cheer camp.
So, do any of you know any good secrets? Like, secrets involving a library?
Library secrets? That's lame.
I went in the library once.
Oh my gosh!
It's only because some mean kids pushed me in.
Tell me about the library.
Library? Is that French or something? Speak English.
Library is English.
I think I had a library pie once.
Oh my god, you ate a pie?
It was just a slice and I was very young.
You people are pathetic.
Sometimes I love my job.
You don't think this bracelet means anything?
That's the problem. It could belong to some shadowy figure following her every move, but then again, it could belong to some neighborhood kid who is peeking at the cheerleaders in their bathing suits. I have no way to know.
What about the note? The the dirty boot, that's gotta mean something.
It could, but for all we know, someone left that piece of paper there 10 years ago. Some weird bookmark or something. At the rate we're going, Rocky Road's gonna have this case solved before we even know who's involved.
Don't say that. The 31st flavor couldn't hold a candle to you. You'll have to deuce her any day.
I knew there was a reason I kept you around.
I don't know. Why don't we take a look at the footage we took the other night? Maybe we'll find something we missed.
Fine. What other choice do we have? See, I told you. Nothing. We've got nothing.
Wait a second. What's that right there? Look, somebody else was there the night at the library.
I don't believe it. I know who that is.
You do?
I thought she transferred, but she must have gone underground.
What, is she in the CIA or something? Who is this kid?
The Gypsy.
So, why did we need my mom's minivan again? Are you worried about something? Do you think there will be an attempt on your life?
Don't get all worked up. It's been a long day and I didn't want to walk home.
You know what I hate about coming to the school at night?
What?
The fact that I know I'll have to be here in a few more hours. It's depressing. I feel like I never leave.
Well, buck up, buckaroo. You're about to parts of school you never even imagined existed.
Will the excitement never end? Who exactly is this Gypsy?
Nobody knows. Some say she's a trapped spirit of a freshman who drowned near the girls' toilet back in the 50s. Or she could just be the night janitor's daughter.
Mr. Bo?
Yep.
I think we were in middle school with a girl named Gypsy Bo.
I'm sure that's just a coincidence. Nobody's even seen her, except me. They tried to call her for stealing paper, but they ended up pinning it on Mr. Bo. That's why they passed him up for the security job and gave it to Rocky Road instead.
How do you know all this?
I've got connections.
Jennifer Diamond and Donald Heaver. To what do I owe this pleasure? Usually the rats and roaches don't come out until later, so I'm surprised to see you here.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't have time for games, Gypsy. Tell me what you know.
No time for small talk either, I see.
My mom didn't raise a fool. I know about the bad blood between us.
Bad blood? What? You never said anything about bad blood here. What kind of bad blood is going on?
And yet you still came, despite how I feel about you. You must be desperate, Jenny.
Just as desperate as one of your prom dates.
Jeden Nachklang fühlt mein Herz, froh und trübe Zeit, wann lesbischen Freund und Schmerz in der Einsamkeit. Wann lesbischen Freund und Schmerz in der Einsamkeit.
You never said anything about it. They should be teaching us these things in school.
Enough with the hoodoo. I heard the same thing on a rerun from Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Oh, Eli! Oh my god, look at it! Look at it! That's me looking up!
We have footage of you outside the library the night one of the break-ins is occurring.
That doesn't mean anything.
We We also have a bracelet that looks suspiciously like the other ones you're wearing.
You can't prove that's mine.
Who else would wear homemade bracelets in the exact same style?
They're not homemade. I bought them at Hot Topic.
Oh, well, still, it's all very suspicious.
You've got nothing, Jenny Diamond. That's why you're here. You've got nothing else to go on.
You're right. I've got nothing. I'm grasping at straws here.
Why should I help you after all you've done to my family?
What'd you do to her family?
Remember how I told you she was caught stealing paper? I'm the one who made the bust. I was young, new to the game, trying to make a name for myself. I thought helping tons of fun was a way to do that.
You cost my father that promotion. Now he's stuck night janitoring while that idiot Rocky Road lives out his dream.
You're the one stealing paper!
Ladies, let's not split hairs here. Jenny is trying to solve this case, but we're at a dead end. He's trying to make Rocky Road look like a fool. But without any information, we can't get anywhere close to solving this caper. I think you know something, and whatever it is, could embarrass Rocky Road, and perhaps get your dad that new promotion he's always wanted.
I knew it kept you around for something, Doc.
Here. You want to jumpstart your case? This is what you get. I won't hand it to you on a silver platter.
Thursday? That's tomorrow.
What would I do without your brilliant powers of deduction? The letters and numbers, what do they mean? Is it some sort of code?
This is your case, Jenny Diamond, not mine.
What about this? Does this mean anything to you?
What do you think my Puma has to be sneezed? It's English. All I can tell you.
Aw, thanks a lot. I thought it was written in Spanish. You're a brilliant psychic. Come on, Doc, let's go.
Before you go, are you reading?
No, thanks. I don't believe in that kind of stuff.
Don't insult the forces that brought you here tonight, Jenny. Pick a card.
Well, that doesn't look pleasant.
This is a warning, Jenny Diamond. You are on a slippery slope. A slippery slope indeed.
Well, that was creepy. Nothing like learning that there's a hermit living in your high school cafeteria.
At least we have a lead. We need to be in Chinatown tomorrow. We're getting close. I can feel it.
I didn't know Hemet had a Chinatown.
It's small, but it's just as seedy as in the big city Chinatowns.
Well, if it isn't Little Miss Muffet and her Tuffet.
I guess that would make you the spider then, wouldn't it, Rocky Road?
Boo! How'd you know it was me?
Who tipped you off?
Well, wouldn't you like to know? Very reliable source. Let's just leave it at that. They said I might find you two sneaking around down here. Seems some cheerleaders saw you around here the other night as well. Very suspicious, Jenny. Wandering school campuses at night. Calling a teacher names. Denying a proposal from the principal. Since our little Jenny Diamond's gone bad.
Hi.
So, are you gonna confess or do I have to take you in?
Ah! Run, don't run!
Thank you.
scrape her off.
I don't know. Look around.
I found some wrapping paper. Oh,
that'll do.
Oh. Bad round your own. Let's go. Bad yard line.
Oh, so much trouble.
I'll get you, Jenny. And your little duck, too. Want some of this?
No.
You sure? This stuff's great. You can't get Chinese like this outside of Chinatown.
You serious?
Yeah.
What about the Panda Express by the mall?
Are you kidding? That's not authentic. Now this is authentic. Now I don't know what it is, but nothing goes great with a steakout like Chinese food.
So, what exactly am I looking for again?
Dirty boots. Find me the dirtiest pair of kicks you can.
You know, my mom is gonna kill me when she finds out I ditched class.
I'd hate to break it to you, Doc, but last night you ran over a yard arc. I think ditching class is gonna come out pretty low on a totem pole.
I hate you sometimes, you know that? I think I've got something. Looks like Biffle Masterson. And Maggie, with some of the cheer pack, too.
Can you see what they're doing?
Looks like they're putting something in a bag.
What?
Can't tell from this angle.
Give me the headphones. Boost the audio.
Need to get rid of her. Too close to the project. Care what you do, expel her or something.
Biffle doesn't like Jenny. Biffle wants a clear field, no interceptions.
I don't like where this conversation is going. Tell me who's in that car, Doc.
Good stuff, right? I don't want to be from cheer.
Biffle needs the aces. Or Biffle's got a reading intervention. Biffle rules. Go Mustang football.
Fishes! Got him! Come on, Doc. Run! Someplace. Spread out. Let's keep hushed tones, Miss Mary. I won't want you to be any more contrary than you already are. Do you understand me, Miss Mary? You want to tell me what's going on?
I don't really know.
Mind your peas and carrots. I don't want to listen to you whistle in the wind.
I don't even know what that means.
It means we've got a pack of goons on our heels, and I want you to tell me why. No sob story, no tap dancing. Just a straight skinny.
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Out of the mouths of babes. Keep rolling, Doc. Start squawking, Polly.
It's big, Jenny.
bigger than you and me and all the rest of us.
Don't give me jive, Mary. What were Maggie and Bippo buying? Was it drugs? Stolen antiquities? Biochemical war devices?
Will they stop at nothing to win a state championship?
No, it's bigger. Answer keys to the standardized tests. Holy shish kebab beef, Doc. They've got someone in on the inside.
What?
They've got a teacher, or even an administrator on the take.
But that...
Who's your connection?
I don't know.
I'm tired of that song, Canary. Sing me another.
It's true. Bippo and Maggie were the only ones that knew anything. They dealt with the source, and the rest of us just stood guard.
Keep trying, Chickadee. I want more.
Stick with one word. Jenny, you're confusing me with all your avian imagery.
Don't make me try dodo, sweetheart. You won't like how that one ends.
All I know is that we were told to look for someone with a dirty boot, and then this filthy car showed up, and they started unloading copies of the answer keys out of the trunk. That's everything I know, I swear.
The trunk?
That's what I said.
The dirty trunk. That's it! Why did I think of it before? The dirty trunk! The gypsy was right. The note's English.
Well, it's not Portuguese.
No, English. It's British. In England, they call the trunk of a car a boot. The dirty boot!
How do you know all this?
I watch on BBC.
So if the note is really English, then it has to be...
Melgrew.
Dastardly.
Come on, we've got to get back to the school.
What about me, Jenny?
What do you want me to say?
I want you to say you'll forgive me. I want you to say that in a world where I'm not a cheerleader, and you're not a high school detective, an internet sensation, that maybe we could be BFFs.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, but every time I try, the words kind of stick in my mouth. Find someone else who deals in dreams. It's not my MO.
I could have screamed. I could have yelled for help.
But you didn't. And I'll always be grateful for that, kid.
I could still.
I won't stop you. Fish gotta swim. Let's get gone, Doc.
What are we gonna do, Jenny? I mean, Rocky Road, I'm sure, has convinced Principal Toshevin that we're behind the break-ins. And the cheerleaders and football players, I'm absolutely sure that they're back by the school by now.
We gotta beat them at their own game.
How are we gonna do that?
I've got a plan, but we'll need the irregulars.
Oh, I hate elementary school kids. They smell like cheese and urine.
Sorry, but they're part of the plan.
What's the plan?
I'm gonna turn myself in.
What do you need?
I need you to cause some trouble.
Boss, we can do that for free.
Looks bad.
It always does.
You sure you want to go through with this?
What else are we gonna do? Homework?
Now you're just talking crazy.
Once we get the signal from my elementary school irregulars, I'm going to try and make it to the main office. You set up camera by Melgrew's car. If this works, we're going to need to tape some evidence.
So, what's the signal?
See you on the flip side, sport.
Solid.
Thank you.
Mary.
I'm sorry, Jenny.
Don't be sorry. Birds gotta fly, right? It's in your nature to be a dizzy dame. I never knew a cheerleader who wasn't.
It's not our fault. It's all the spinning. Sometimes we can't tell which way is up.
That's usually when you fall on your face.
Hello, Diamond. Looks like you're in the rough.
Hello yourself, badass.
What did she just call you?
Nothing. It's my last name.
Oh, lucky you.
Enough of this small talk.
Bippo rules!
Shut up, Bippo! We've got you now, Diamond, and now you're gonna pay for all the trouble you've caused.
Well, what do we have here? Looks like we have ourselves a situation. Don't you guys have a practice you should be rushing off to or something?
Do we? Let's go. Coach is gonna be pissed.
We're just having a friendly conversation with our pal Jenny here. No need for the fuzz.
Sorry, Shortstack. Miss Diamond and I have a date with Destiny.
Destiny Carlton? I have her in my first period.
Look, it's a figure of speech. Just disperse. Jenny Diamond, you're coming with me.
That'll do, Pig. That'll do. Tell Malgu to dispose of the goods. Jenny Diamond's on the loose.
You think you're so smart, don't you? You just think you're the belle of the ball. Well, I've got news for you. You're nothing. You're less than nothing.
How can you be less than nothing?
It's a mathematical thing, like negative numbers.
I still don't get it.
Well then, let me explain it to you.
Get the evidence to Jennifer, Donald.
I don't want my father to have to mob up you for the rest of his life.
I didn't know the Renaissance Fair was in town. Get out of my way, freak.
You may not pass, Marguerite's badass!
What are you gonna do about it? Put a gypsy curse on me?
The evil eye is great, but I get better results with the right hook.
So, nothing is zero, right?
Right.
So you would be like -5 or -15.
But that's numbers. We're talking about physical matter here.
Do you want me to draw another graph?
Well, Jennifer Diamond, I never thought I'd have you in here.
You still don't, tons of fun. I didn't do it.
Really, Jenny? Because Rocky Road here has prepared a very convincing report. Not to mention your recent altercation with Mr. Mulgrew.
Once I tell you what I know about Mulgrew, you'll be saying the same thing about him.
Did you and Donald Heaver pose as library inspectors?
Yes.
And were you on campus late the other night?
We were.
And did you drive with Rocky Road on the hood of your car before scraping her off the moving vehicle with a tube of wrapping paper?
Well, when you put it that way, it does sound pretty harsh.
Sounds like a complete confession to me, Chief.
And what does that sound like to you, the Gettysburg Address?
That was foul, Jenny. This is a small room.
I'm afraid I have no choice but to sign these papers of expulsion.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Stop! Stop right there! I've got proof that Jenny is innocent.
About time you showed up, Doc! I was starting to sweat.
What's that smell?
That's justice.
Ugh, I think it's cabbage.
Well, it looks like Bippo, Maggie, and Mary are really settling into detention.
Yeah. From now on, they'll have to study for standardized tests just like the rest of us.
Well, I hope you like restructuring, because thanks to you, that's what we're getting.
But it'll be a restructuring one by honesty.
I may lose my job.
An honest firing. That should be some consolation.
Huh. I'll tell that to my creditors. They'll be very consoled.
So, how's the new yard dark working out?
He's fine. He's just creepy enough to keep the kids in line. That's something, I guess.
What about Mulgrew?
The district office is taking personal interest in his disciplinary action.
But who at the district office? I want to make sure Melgar gets what he deserves.
Topman.
But who?
Topman.
It was a sunny day when he came into my office. He'd lost something. Something important. And he wanted me to find it. Sunny days always make me jumpy. The brighter the sunlight, the deeper the shadows.
Jenny, I need you to help me find my lunch. I can't find it. I need to make way for Esther.
Tragic.
You gotta help me, Jenny.
He was desperate. I could see it in his eyes. I've always been a sucker for desperate eyes. That probably says more about my relationships end early than anything else. Where did you last see your lunch?
Over there.
What did you have?
I brought a bunch of Twinkies and a pasta from home.
Sounds appetizing.
I think I know where your lunch is.
It was abandoned. Abandoned lunches have to be searched and disposed of.
No way.
Some cases are like that. They work themselves out without ever having to let your seat get cold. And I hate colds.
Thank you.
is over the moors.
Over the moors?
Yeah, the moors' backyard, next to the Johnsons.
Oh.
Come on, let's go. Mystery solved. Is it set up?
Yep.
Cool. Now's our chance for a shot at internet fame.
They had a koala sanctuary in Hemet.
Yeah, it's really tucked away. Jenny, I need your help.
How convenient you show up with a mystery once the camera's rolling. Not that it's only coincidental.
Way to ruin a moment, Doc. Jenny, please, someone has shaved my koala while I wasn't looking. That sounds like something you should talk to the nurse about.
Please, Jenny?
Like the mystery solved.
Koalas are vengeful creatures.
diamonds, they're tough to break.
Come on, girls. It's past my bedtime. Do we leave?
Yes, okay.
Wrong, Doc!
Okay.
Where's the flower bed?
Are you gonna confess or do I have to take you in?
Are you having fun, Stacey?
Thrill of my life.
But I got a hunch.
Way to go, Janet. Just trashed the library.
I've got a hunch.
I got a hunch. And it's a hunchback.
I didn't know the Renaissance Fair was in town. Get out of my way, freak.
You may not pass.
I didn't know the Renaissance Fair was in town. Get out of my way, freak.
You may not pass, Margaret Vatas!
Wait, whose line do we start?
I wasn't sure if she was supposed to say that.
No, we're gonna take it from your...
Feel bad?
It's just an anthropological...
Put him in a close-up.
It was abandoned. Abandoned lunches have to... Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, go in. Show him your karate skills. Hey-ya!
You're gonna punch him. Spread your legs.
Oh, God!
Nailed off your face!
Lizzie. Chloe. Emma. Emily.
You did.
I did it backwards, but it worked. Okay. One more time. Jeffrey. Lizzie. Chloe. Emma. Emily.
You did it again!
Yeah, switch places, that'll work better. Alright.
Now you're gonna say Emily, Emma.
No, okay.
Why don't we speak to her, Anna?
I thought you said we were gonna stand up right then.
No. Stand up on it, that's when you fall on your face. You have to say, we can't help it, it's all the flippers.
Ha ha, just kidding.
Ready? Press, don't lean on the tree, the principal's watching us.
Hello yourself, badass.
What did she just call you?
Nothing, it's my last name.
Oh, lucky you.
Enough of this small talk.
Yes!
Jenny, I need you to help me find my lunch. I can't find it. I need to make way for wrestling.
Tragic.
Bitbull rules. Oh, son of
Bitbull rules. Go Mustang football. Ready?
I need my finger. I'm sorry.
5, 4, 3.
Bitbull rules. Mustang foot.
Bitbull rules, go Mustang football.
Zelig versig vor den Welt ohne Hass verschließt. Einen Freund am Busen hält und mit dem genießt.
I'm supposed to be giving it to both, aren't I?
I think he did it to him.
I think you know something, and whatever it is, perhaps could get you that new promotion he's always wanted.
And it could make Roger Rose look like a fool.
And a fool he is.
Need to get
Girls,
rid of her.
You're the ones I'm talking to. You're ruining my shop. You go all the way over there and sit down, Sydney, or you're going in a hot car. Like a dog.
Calm down.
And there'll be no water for you. All right. You ready? 5.
Let's take a look at the footage I took the other night. Maybe we'll find something we missed.
Why don't you look at it? That would be good, Jason, but probably without Mrs. Bailey prompting you. Try her again.
Not that it's not totally coincidental.
Wait around a moment, Doc. Jenny, please. Mike Waller was today when I wasn't looking. Sounds like something
what?
We should talk. Sorry.
Good? Oh, except for Charlie, it's ain't good!
Hey, Pooper Scooper. What you gonna do with that pig sticker?
Steak pig.
I can see the bike rack. We're not exactly wandering through Appalachia.
So, no, I'm kidding.
No, I'm kidding.
Three. You sit. Oh. Sorry. It's the first time that happens, you sit.